Hello, I'm Dr. Nandkishore SK, working as consultant urologist at Aster RB Hospital. Now I'm briefing about the complications and prevention of kidney stones. So I'll talk about complications. The complications, whether if there is a treatment of the stone or without the treatment of the stone. So I already mentioned for some people who are ignoring their symptoms, but they're keeping their stones to be there. So what it can do, it can bring about an infection. So which can actually erode the kidney and damage the kidney, and a long-standing blockage of the kidney can bring about destruction of the kidney and bringing about a kidney failure. So ultimately leading on to dialysis, which is an artificial kidney which will work as kidney, but it will be outside the body. And subsequently, if at all, you know, is fed up with the dialysis, then there will be something called kidney transplant. So these are all the late complications if at all a particular person ignores his symptoms or don't take a treatment at appropriate time. And the complications with the treatment, if I undergo a certain treatment, whether there are any complications of the treatment. So one of the complications what we commonly in minimally invasive, like I am talking about extracorporeal shock, there can be some amount of a bigger stone if at all forms into pieces and it can block the ureter, then you can have more pain, then you can have fever. So we see that will not happen during that period of time. Then we have something like making a hole in the kidney and doing the chance of bleeding is there. So if there is bleeding, then we have to block the bleeding. That is what we will be taking as a thing. Now, subsequently, we have a complication as fever, infection while doing these procedures. These are as the complications of the treatments. But these complications can be definitely avoided. And in certain percentage of times, it can be unavoidable. So for them, we take as precautions, we treat them beforehand as well as in the post-operative period. Now everyone's question is how to prevent new stone formation. The classical statement is once a stone former is a stone former for the life. So if he forms one stone, the chance of him having another stone in the next 5 years will be 50%. So can we prevent that, or can we postpone the new stone occurrence? Like 5 years, instead of 5 years, can we make it as 7 years? Can we make it 10 years? How to do that? So one is the lifestyle changes. What we usually teach all the patients, one is drinking habits. So many people dehydrate themselves. Dehydration itself is one of the commonest causes of forming stones. So we always tell our patients at least 12 to 14 glasses of liquids every day, something like 150 to 200 ml per hour. So we want you to take something like every hour one glass of water. That will be more better rather than taking binge drinking, 1 liter in the morning, 1 liter in the afternoon, 1 liter in the night. That would not be beneficial. Rather than keeping it drinking on a regular intervals, that is much beneficial. Then the couch potatoes are one of those commonest people who will have obesity and getting diabetes, hypertension. These are all prone for having stones. So we have to tell them to be mobile, physically active, and those are the people who will have less stones. And there are certain dietary restrictions. We do something called urinary metabolic workup and see what are the chemicals which has been produced more in the particular person's urine. So we try to manage if at all a particular person has more of oxalate. We tell how to take oxalate free diet or an oxalate restricted diet. So we taper or tailor made customize the treatment chart for them how to prevent future stones. So this is a just overview of the management about kidney stones, and subsequently we will be talking on other subjects in the next coming videos. Thank you.